This video gives you a quick overview of the ICM's web interface. The home page shows the general status of the system and the state of the antenna. In this example, the system is online, meaning it's connected to the mini VSAT broadband service. The antenna is tracking beam 39 of the satellite located at 50 degrees west, and is reporting a signal strength, or SNR, of about 9 dB. You can also see that the voice service is ready for use. Line 1 is available to place a phone call, while line 2 is disabled. The home page also shows your true heading, reported by your NMEA device, your latitude and longitude, reported by the antenna's built-in GPS, and the antenna's pointing direction relative to the bow. Now let's go to the Settings tab, where you can configure the system. To make any changes, you'll need to log in with the administrator password. Under Network Settings, you can change the ICM's network configuration. You can change the IP address and the DHCP settings of the high-speed LAN. You can disable the local web cache, although you should keep it enabled for faster web browsing. And you can turn on the ICM's built-in Wi-Fi. If you enable Wi-Fi, be sure to select a security mode and set a password to prevent unauthorized access. Under No Transmit Zones, you can set up a No Transmit Zone to prevent the antenna from transmitting in a hazardous direction. Remember, the antenna transmits RF energy that is potentially harmful. Under Tracking Avoidance Zones, you can set up a Tracking Avoidance Zone to prevent the antenna from tracking in a direction that has poor reception. For example, there might be partial blockage or interference. Under Account, you can change the administrator password. You can also change the vessel name that appears on the web interface. Finally, under Other, you can change the names of the phone lines. Okay, let's move on to the Support tab, which is particularly useful for technicians. Here you'll find comprehensive status information, including antenna orientation, software versions, serial numbers, and modem data. If any errors were detected, you'll find them in the event history. You can also restart the system, view the online help, or generate a log file. The operational log captures a wealth of diagnostic information. Now let's go to the Updates tab, where you can upload new software to the antenna. If you downloaded the update file from the KVH portal, you can upload it from your laptop or a thumb drive. If you don't have the file, you can download the latest version over the mini VSAT broadband connection. Finally, the Comm Box tab allows you to log in to the Comm Box Control webpage if an optional Comm Box network management bundle is installed. Otherwise, this tab will offer some information about KVH's Comm Box solutions. This concludes our brief tour of the ICM's web interface. If you have any questions about the interface, please contact KVH Technical Support.